गुड मॉर्निंग गाइस, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विथ अ न्यू कॉन्सेप्ट इन अ जीएसटी आईपी सिलेबस, कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ एग्जेम्पशंस व्हिच इज कवर्ड अंडर सेक्शन 11 ऑफ द इनकम, सेक्शन 11 ऑफ सीजीएसटी एक्ट व्हिच वी कैन कैरी डेफिनेटली 5 to 6 मार्क्स. नाउ प्लीज अंडरस्टैंड द लॉजिक बिहाइंड इट. दिस इज द हेडिंग इन योर नोटबुक. इट्स गिवन इन पेज नंबर 40 ऑफ योर नोट्स व्हिच इज सेंड टू यू थ्रू पीडीएफ. दिस इज द हेडिंग, concept of exemptions. Now please understand, there are more than 100 plus services. There are more than 100 plus services where GST council decided. There are more than 100 plus services you have where GST council decided. We will mention those services as exempt services. Exempt bole to no GST on those services. We are exempting those services from GST, that's why it's called exempt services, no GST, 100. But we will read these services industry wise. If you read this particular services industry wise, trust me, it becomes very easy for you to analyze the concept. We'll read from 13 industries point of view, those services are exempt. Now listen, central government clarified, we will learn what are exempt. We will learn what are exempt. We will learn. It means apart from these 100 plus services, apart from these 100 plus services, any other service will be taxable. On that, GST will also apply. So, we are not learning what is taxable services, but we will learn what are exempt services. Exempt services bole to understand 100 plus 0. Taxable bole to 100 plus GST of 18 rupees. Think properly. In this chapter, you better be a service recipient. Better be a service recipient point of view. You think you can relate to the topic. You are also thinking from provider point of view, he will give you a bill of 100 plus 0. 100 plus 0 exempt, 100 plus 18 taxable. But we are not learning which are taxable service, we are learning which are exempt services, which is given under section 11 of the income tax, which gives powers to central government to exempt the services on the recommendations given by GST council. Is the background clear? Section 10, listen now. Section 7 speaks about supply, 8 mixed or composite supply, 9 the chargeability, 10 composition scheme. Now today we are starting with 11. So 7 to 10 is completed. 7 to 10 is completed. 9 mein again we have 9-1, 9-2, 9-3, 9-4, 9-5. 7 mein 7 subsection 1 clause A, 7 sub clause B, then 7-1C, 7-2A, 7-2B and nonsense. Whatever it is. Chhod do. We are only bothered today with section 11 where government has given us more than 100 plus services and they says on that services no GST because those are exempt services. In this video, we'll cover 6 to 7 categories of services or 6 to 7 industries. In this video, we'll cover 6 to 7 industries of services. The first one, check in your notebook, is transportation of passenger services. The first one, transportation of passenger services. Please understand the logic now. Do not read. I am covering this chart. Transportation. Do not read until I tell you. If you want to write this, I'll give you time also. Pehle sun lo, then likh lo, then you read this. Theek hai? Mode of transport. Mode of transport. My social studies faculty told in fourth class, there are four modes of transport. Railways, roadways, waterways, and airways. I hope at least you know this. Now, assuming I am traveling through railways, through a train. Train mein varieties we have. You are traveling through metro. Now, government clarified, whatever I'll write here, these are exempt services. These are what? Exempt services. Bole to, if I am traveling in Hyderabad metro from Amirpet to High Tech City, I am paying some amount to the counter fellow, 100 rupees. I will not pay GST on that because that service is exempt services. So I'll pay, assuming the ticket price from that particular place to that place is 100. Rail ticket price 100. I will pay 100 plus 0. Or I can say like this. The ticket counter fellow will collect from you 100 plus 0. Or I can say this. You will pay 100 plus 0. That is called exempt service. If you travel through metro, monorail, MMTS, tramway, sleeper class, general compartment. So, for example, I am traveling from Hyderabad to Ramagundam in a train, in a sleeper class. Am I supposed to pay the ticket price? Yes. But that is exempt service. Bolto, he assume ticket price is 250. 250 plus 0. We are not learning which are taxable services. We are learning which are exempt. Up to now. In this, sleeper class is covered. General compartment is covered. Think opposite now. I am traveling through railways in 3-tier AC. Is it covered under exempt services? No. It means it is taxable. 2-tier AC, taxable. 1-tier AC, also taxable. Because what are covered? Only these are covered. So, exam point of view, you should know what is exempt. If he gives anything other than exempt, that is taxable. So, apan ye nahi pad rahe, taxable kya hai? Apan ye pad rahe, exempt kya hai? We are not learning what are taxable services. We are learning what are exempt services. So, if you travel through railways by these modes in railways, that is exempt services, it means he will only charge ticket price, he will not add GST. But if you are traveling to 1-tier, 2-tier, 3-tier, he will charge you GST. But wo yaad na karo ko, when will charge you? Yaad rakho, when is it exempt? Exam mein ulta diya to you should remember. That's why charge is given. Next. If you are traveling through, acha, metro means you know, we have in Hyderabad. MMTS means local trains, Mumbai. Monorail means one track. Mono means single. Tramway bolto, the track will be on the roads, like in Kolkata, West Bengal. Sleeper class, you know, in normal train. General compartment also, you know, in normal train. But what are not covered in this? First tier, 2-tier, 3-tier, it means that it's taxable. If you are travelling through roadways, by bus, public transport, TSRTC, exempt. Both I am travelling from Himayat Nagar to SR Nagar through bus, he will take 10 rupees, 10 rupees plus 0 he will take, because it is an exempt services. Stage carrier buses. Please Google right now stage carrier buses and go to images. You will understand what is stage carrier. Double decker, triple decker, bade bade buses ko stage carrier bolte. Check in Google. I'll wait. clear? Stage carrier buses, but it has to be non-AC buses. But exam mein kya deta malum bun? Stage carrier bus, AC bus. What is exempt? Non-AC. It means AC bus will be taxable. Simple. Next. Contract carrier buses. Ye bhi Google kar lena. Contract carrier buses. Again non-AC. For other than tourism. For other than tourism. All these are exempt services. If you want, I'll give you time to note down also. Then we'll read this chart. Okay. Other than tourism is exempt. Shall we continue? Now listen. Roadways. Buses ho gaye. Now we are talking only for discussion purpose. I booked a Ola. I booked a cab from my home to airport, airport to home. Those are called taxis. Those are called radio taxis. Those are called motor taxis. Is it covered here? No. Well, those are not exempt. Well, those are taxable. But recent clarification has come. If it is metered cab, wo bhi exempt rehta. I hope you have seen in movies black color taxis in Mumbai which have a meter. If you are traveling in those meter cabs, then also exempt bolto. The driver will only charge that fare, the transportation charges, he will not add GST. And this also I hope you know, if you are traveling in auto rickshaw, then also the driver will not say, hey, wait, pay 20 rupees plus GST. He will only take 20 or 30 or 40. He will not add at GST. So if roadways, these are exempt. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Please all these 5, you have to write in this only. I don't have place here. You write all 5 in this column. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yahan likhna. So we are learning which services are exempt. Bole to, when you travel in those particular modes, you should only pay the ticket price. You need not pay the GST amount because government clerks, those are exempt. Third one, waterways. Third one, waterways. Inland waterways. Inland waterways. Or a ship. Other than tourism purpose. These two are exempt. If you are traveling through waterways. Inland waterways bolta government ka rehta wo. Government ke ships. For example, a ship has been introduced from Mumbai to Goa, Goa to Mumbai. One day ship. That is inland waterways. That is mode of transit waterways, inland waterways. When I travel in that ship fellow will only charge the fare. 10,000 rupees the fare. Plus GST will be zero because exempt service. And airways. It's very confusing, sir. And it will take lot of revision from your end to understand all this. Because exam mein puchha 6 marks ko. Airways. If you are traveling from or traveling to Meghalaya, Mizoram, Sikkim, Nagaland, Tripura, these are exempt. Bolte when you for example, I'm traveling from Hyderabad to Meghalaya. Ticket price airfare is 5,000. I'll pay 5,000 plus zero. But if you're traveling from or traveling to other than this place, for the Hyderabad to Goa, it's not covered, although on that GST will apply. ये सर्विसेस में जीएसटी नहीं लगता. एनी सर्विस अपार्ट फ्रॉम दिस जीएसटी विल अप्लाई एंड इट विल बी 100 प्लस टैक्स फॉर ऑल दिस सर्विसेस. 100 प्लस जीरो अज्यूमिंग द बेस प्राइस, द टिकट प्राइस इज 100. दिस इज अ फर्स्ट मोड ऑफ ट्रांसपोर्टेशन, दैट इज अ फर्स्ट इंडस्ट्री, ट्रांसपोर्टेशन ऑफ पैसेंजर सर्विसेस. प्लीज कॉपी दिस एंड देन read this particular chart. I'll give you exactly 8 minutes to copy this and read this. It's 5:20 in my watch. I'll show you the watch when I start. It should be 5:30. 10 minutes to write, even though given, and then read. You will understand. Start. 10 minutes I'm going to write and read. Chalo jaldi. I hope you are continuing writing, sir. First, you have to copy this. All these are exam services under transportation of passenger. Then you read the notes, because I can't do both. I can only explain you, and notes are properly given. Bolto, apart from this, anything happens, it is a taxable service. Taxable bole to 100 plus tax. Exam bole to 100 plus zero. So listen, airways mein only these. If I'm going to Goa to other states, then taxable. Ropeway, cable car, anything I'm doing, that also taxable. Ye contract carrier non AC diya, AC diya, taxable. Contract 18 non AC diya, tourism diya, then also taxable, because it's other than tourism. So you have to be very careful in exam. That's the reason a chart, proper chart is given. Please go through this. I'll give you time. I'm not going. I already told you motor cabs, radio taxis. Liklo example here. Ola, Uber, and your
yellow taxis which has GPS installed, those are taxable. I hope you must have copied this. Now please read this. Go through this. Relate to whatever you have wrote, it will match. Okay. 2 minutes more before I continue. Like this, if I cover 5-6 industries today, then every video I'll cover that and we'll wind up in 2-3 videos. Today's agenda is to cover 5-6 industries. First industry was transportation of passengers. Second, we'll go to healthcare, hospitals. I did not make you write what are taxable, I made you write what are exempt. So other than whatever you wrote, those are taxable. Like railways mein agar mono sleeper class likhe, general compartment AC ne likhe, iska matlab kya hota, what does it mean? If you are traveling in normal AC, either 1-tier, 2-tier, 3-tier AC, that is taxable. Bolto, you have to not only pay the rail ticket price, you should also pay on that GST. Government says when you can pay more for the AC, you are also capable to pay the GST or tax amount also. That's the logic behind it. Chal. 5:30 okay sir, we'll start in the second one. Second one I'll read from the notebook only. Be careful. Everyone. Healthcare bracket mein hospital doctor. Chup chap sunte jao. Sunte jao. Healthcare services provided by hospitals, clinical establishments. First one, sunte jao. First one says, you go to hospital for treatment. Unfortunately, nowadays people are going for COVID. Bill is coming 10 lakhs. On the 10 lakhs, hospital will not add GST because it's covered under exempt services. Healthcare services provided by hospital. Next, what if hospital like Apollo, Yashoda Care, what if I go to private hospitals? This is private hospital. Okay. What if I go to private clinic of the doctor? Those are also exempt. He will only charge for the operation or his consultancy. On that, he will not add GST. Second one, healthcare services provided by authorized medical representation doctors. So whether it's provided by hospitals or private doctors in their private clinic, those are exempt from GST. I am not telling they will not charge their services amount. I am telling they will not charge GST on their services. Third, paramedics
like lab assistant, physiotherapist, nursing staffs. Then lot of nursing homes we have in Hyderabad. Physiotherapist will have, if sportsmen will follow the physiotherapist for exercise, their service is also exempt. So three, provided by hospitals, doctors in their private clinic, and paramedics, lab assistants, physiotherapists, nursing staff, and your diagnostic centers also exempt. On that also no GST. Vijay Diagnostic Center is the best example. Clear? Healthcare services means diagnosis, like Vijay Diagnostic Center, or treatment. What do they treat? Your illness, injury, deformity, abnormality, pregnancy. Recognized system in India, bolto healthcare also covers if you are allopathy doctor, yoga doctor, naturopathy, Siddha, homeopathy doctor, all these are exempt from GST. All these are exempt from GST. Am I clear? So, chalo. First, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Chalo, once again. How many are there? 7. We are in which industry now, sir? Healthcare industry. First one, kya bolta? Provided by hospitals, private doctors, in doctors in private clinic and paramedics exempt, and he gave the definition of healthcare. Usme yoga aata, allopathy aata, homeopathy aata, and all. Okay. Now come to point number 5. What if I am an animal doctor? I treat animals. That's called I'm a veterinary doctor. Those are also exempt. Whether you treat patients, that comes under 1, human beings. You treat animals, comes under 5, that is also exempt. Check number 5 now. Veterinary also related to animals. Next, point number 6. I run an ambulance service company. Ambulance service bole to, any accident happens anywhere, people can call my company. I will send my ambulance. That ambulance will send that patient to the nearest hospital as soon as possible. But I will collect charges from the patient, not patient, patient, how can he pay? Attendant. Government clarified those services also exempt. Bole to, I can only charge from there the transportation charges. I will not add GST. That ambulance can be private ambulance or ambulance of the hospital, does not matter. Samajh mein aaya the scenario? Point number 6. Point number 6. Please check. A point here is I cannot cover more than 4 to 5 industries, sir, because you will go MAD mad. That's the reason I'm going slow. Chike? 1 is done. 5 is done. 6 is done. Now come to 3. Listen. Logic samjhata hu iska, pehle sun lo. If you want, you can write. You go to a private clinic of a doctor, you are not well, he will give you injection and he will throw the injection in front of you in the dustbin and he will wash his hands. What will he do with that injection which is general? Can he throw in the normal garbage what we do like in our homes? Answer is no. He will call a company. The company will come, take the wastage of the dustbin and will reprocess and process. It will be processed and the waste will be dumped in an appropriate manner. But for that, doctor has to make that payment to that company. So the services provided by that company to the doctor, where they are sending a van, collecting all the used injections, reprocessing it and throwing in an appropriate manner, doctor will pay amount to that company. Doctor will pay the amount without GST, exempt, 100 plus 0 or I can say that company will collect the money from the doctor 100 plus 0. That is covered in point number 3. Please write the example what I gave you. वो एग्जाम्पल लिखो व्हाट द जो अभी मैं पढ़ा बोला वो एग्जाम्पल लिखो अभी यहाँ ठीक है चल सो वी आर डन विथ 1, 3, 5, 6 नंबर 2 नाउ व्हाट इज हैपनिंग इज आई विल टेक माय एग्जांपल ओनली माय रिलेटिव्स एग्जांपल ओनली माय कजन ब्रदर्स वाइफ वाज प्रेग्नेंट एंड दे कॉल्ड अ कंपनी दे अप्रोच द कंपनी द कंपनी क्या करती After the child is born, that company will come to the hospital, will take the stem cells of the child and preserve it. What will the company do? Aap is bolo, when the child is born, they will call that company will come to the hospital, will take the stem cells of the child and it will be preserved. Reason, later on if any health problem comes to the child, any health problem comes to the child, it can be resolved by using the stem cell which is preserved by that company. But for that, my cousin is required to make some payment to that company. And government clarified on that no GST. Also my cousin will pay 100 plus 0 or they will collect 100 plus 0. Please write that example here. That is called core blood bank preservation of stem cells. This is a technical word, I can't help. I hope at least anyone have heard in your life the stem cells concept. Stem cells concept. Please read. Shall we continue? Now, point number 4. Listen now. Generally, you see public toilets on the roads in order for the Indian cleanliness or Swachh Bharat Abhiyan campaign. You use those public toilets. Those are also exempt services. It means you will only pay 2 rupees, 3 rupees. He will not ask you to pay 3 rupees plus GST, 5 rupees plus GST. No, those are exempt. You will only pay the fees what they are charging, 2 rupees, 3 rupees or 5 rupees. That's point number 4. Facilities of bathroom, washrooms, lavatories, urinal or toilets. Those are public washrooms we are talking about. Now listen. Again 2 minutes I'm giving you. Read 1 to 6 once again. Sir, ऐसा बार बार पढ़े तो ही याद रहेगा. Else it's very confusing. Trust me, I'm covering in an industry manner point of view. Becomes easy for you. We have more than 100+ services. 1 to 6 वापिस पढ़ो. These are under healthcare, second industry. All are exempt services. Exam में कुछ और दिया apart from these 6. Taxable. Read 1 to 6 quick. ठीक है, नेक्स्ट वन 7, दिस इंपॉर्टेंट. इफ यू आर डूइंग ट्रांसप्लांटेशन और प्लास्टिक सर्जरीज, इफ यू आर चेंजिंग योर फेस, एक्टर जनरली डू एंड ऑल. नाउ गवर्नमेंट क्लैरिफाइड फॉर दिस वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्लैरिफिकेशंस कम फॉर ट्रांसप्लांटेशन प्लास्टिक कॉस्मिक. गवर्नमेंट क्लैरिफाइड, इफ यू आर सिटिंग इन योर हाउस, फायर टुक प्लेस and you are burnt, your face got burnt, due to that they are doing plastic surgery, those services are exempt. But if you are doing plastic surgery only to enhance your beauty or any part of your body or the face, those are taxable. When it is exempt, if you are doing plastic surgery because to restore the face, my face got burnt due to fire, or functions of the body on account of abnormality. So if you're doing plastic surgery because of this reason, it is exempt. If you're doing for other than this reason, it is taxable. It means even Bollywood actor, Hollywood actor does for enhancing the beauty, they come under this taxable. It means they have to pay to the doctor charges plus GST. Here we have to pay only the doctor charges. Here we have to pay doctor charges plus GST. Read the 7th one now. This one. That's the 7th one. Okay. Now this is given in your RTP. Mark as important. Latest clarifications has come. Sir, you have to remember there is no other option. You have to remember this case. Important hai ye. These 6 services again are exempt kate. These 4 services are taxable kate. Bolto 100 plus 0 aata yaha ya 100 plus 18 aata. Sale of medicines in hospital. I hope you know. In the hospital you find pharmacy shops. He will sell you medicines. On that sale, no GST. I am not clarifying. GST council has clarified. Renting rooms to patients in hospitals. I hope you know. They will give you beds. If it's a surgery, 3 days you have to be in the hospital. They'll charge for the room rent. On that service also no GST. That is called renting of rooms. Services provided by independent or outside doctors. I met with an accident or heart attack, but the hospital does not have a heart specialist. They called a doctor from another hospital. That service is also exempt. When we say services are exempt, GST say exempt hai, but you have to pay the amount for the services what you are getting, but you not pay GST. 4. Generally, when a patient is admitted into hospital, the food will be provided by the hospital only. Suno ye, food supply to inpatients as per advice of the doctor. Isme patient underline karo. Inpatient. Iska matlab hota, generally they will have a canteen. Canteen will send the food in a boxes to each room. Patients exempt. But if they are providing the food to doctors, nursing staff, patient ke sath ek attendant bhi rehta, those are taxable under link to the first point. food supplied to attenders, visitors, doctors, staff by hospital are taxable. Clear? Next, rule number 2. Generally, hospital will have a canteen. What if hospital does not have a canteen? They will call one caterer and will they send the food to hospital we have to give to patients. Caterer will send to hospital. Those services are also taxable. When the food is sent by caterer to the hospital. This one. Food services provided by third party to third party bracket mein caterer. And all this ek bar pad lena. All this ek bar pad lena. Chalo, 3 minutes you have. Read. I know more data is going into your brain, but there is no other option. We have to cover 100 plus services. Now listen. In this, we covered 7 services, not 1. We took 1 industry. 7 services are covered. We did not cover 1 service. 7 services under 1 industry. We have to cover 100 plus services. We covered here 7, here we covered 4. 7 plus 4, 11 is done. 10% is done. Chalo, read. Please read. 2 minutes, 3 minutes here. Please read. Okay, so this completes 2 services, sir. Number 1, transportation of passenger services. Number 2, admission services. Now number 2, healthcare services. Now comes number 3, admission services. Admission services. Chal. Now listen. अब लॉजिक समझाए तुम सुन लो रे एक अमेंडमेंट भी आया इसमें अमेंडमेंट ऑल्सो आई विल टेल यू वेट लेट मी आई एम डाउनलोडिंग गिव मी 1 मिनट आई एम डाउनलोडिंग दैट अमेंडमेंट Chal. Amendment I have downloaded, I'll tell you what to do. Admission services or entertainment sector. Services by way of admission to museum, for example. Suno sir, yahi samajh mein aa jana aapko. My friend came from USA. I and my friend is going to Salar Jung Museum, Hyderabad. I have to pay the entry charges, 100 rupees. Government clarified, or on that इट इज एन एग्जेम्प्ट सर्विस. बोले तो वॉट ऑन दैट यू नीड नॉट पे द GST, यू शुड ओनली पे द एंट्री टिकट. एंट्री टिकट कितना है? 100. सो इट इज एग्जेम्प्ट, लिख लो ब्रैकेट, इररेस्पेक्टिव ऑफ टिकट प्राइस. टिकट प्राइस 1000 है तो 1000 प्लस 0, 10,000 है तो 10,000 प्लस 0. सो इफ यू आर गोइंग टू एनी म्यूजियम, नेशनल पार्क, वाइल्ड लाइफ सेंचुरी, टाइगर रिजर्व और जू, यू शुड ओनली पे द टिकट प्राइस विदाउट GST और टिकट प्राइस प्लस 0, बिकॉज दोज आर एग्जेम्प्ट सर्विसेज. कौन से? म्यूजियम, नेशनल पार्क, वाइल्ड लाइफ सेंचुरी, टाइगर रिजर्व एंड जू. वापिस बोलो, म्यूजियम, नेशनल पार्क, वाइल्ड लाइफ सेंचुरी, टाइगर रिजर्व एंड जू, दोज आर एग्जेम्प्ट. नेक्स्ट, इफ यू आर गोइंग टू सर्कस, अ डांस परफॉर्मेंस शो, बैले शो, एनी अवार्ड फंक्शन, फीफा, आईफा, एनी कॉन्सर्ट, सम सिंगर केम इन हैदराबाद, जस्टिन बार्बर, बीबर, पेजेंट, ब्यूटी कॉम्पिटिशन, म्यूजिकल परफॉर्मेंस, एनी स्पोर्टिंग इवेंट, IPL, और एडमिशन टू रिकॉग्नाइज स्पोर्ट्स बॉडी. सो इफ यू आर गोइंग टू दीस इवेंट्स, आप सर्कस में जा रहे टू सी द सर्कस शो, डांस शो, थिएटरिकल परफॉर्मेंस, ड्रामा शो, यू आर गोइंग टू अवार्ड फंक्शंस, यू आर गोइंग टू म्यूजिक फंक्शन, म्यूजिकल फंक्शंस, कॉन्सर्ट, IPL, क्रिकेट मैचेस, फुटबॉल मैचेस, देन गवर्नमेंट सेज चेक द टिकट प्राइस पर पर्सन. वॉट यू विल चेक? टिकट प्राइस पर पर्सन. इफ इट इज लेस देन 500 एग्जेम्प्ट, मोर देन 500 टैक्सेबल. बोले तो इफ द टिकट प्राइस इज 400, वी हैव टू पे 400 प्लस 0. इफ टिकट प्राइस इज 700, वी हैव टू पे 700 प्लस GST. दैट इफ यू कम अंडर कैटेगरी 2 केस. That if you come under category 2 case. Category 1 में whether amount is 1000, 10,000, 200, 300 exempt. Category 2 में if the ticket price up to 500 exempt, more than 500 taxable. समझ में आया difference? चलो start reading 1 and 2. चलो चलो guys, चलो चलो. ठीक है, वी विल ऐड वन मोर ट्री, फिफ्थ वन, बिकॉज इट्स एन अमेंडमेंट. आई राइट द अमेंडमेंट इन द स्क्रीन इन नेक्स्ट 5 मिनट्स. नंबर 3, दिस आर एडमिशन. वेन एवर यू गो, यू हैव टू पे द टिकट, एंट्री टिकट. वी आर कवरिंग वेदर यू शुड पे विद GST, विदाउट GST. हियर विदाउट GST, हियर ऑल्सो विदाउट GST. इफ द टिकट इज अप टू 500, मोर देन 500 टिकट प्लस GST. नंबर 3, इफ यू आर गोइंग टू आर्कियोलॉजिकल साइट्स, चार मीनार, कुतुब मीनार, गेटवे ऑफ इंडिया, गोलकोंडा फोर्ट, ताजमहल, दोज आर ऑल्सो एग्जेम्प्ट. बोलते यू शुड ओनली पे द एंट्री टिकट विदाउट GST, नो GST. एंड नंबर 4, एडमिशन टू फीफा अंडर 17, एडमिशन टू फीफा अंडर 17 वर्ल्ड कप मैचेस हेल्ड इन इंडिया ऑल्सो एग्जेम्प्ट. It means FIFA happened in 2017 for FIFA under 17. Women's FIFA also is happening in India in 2020. Used to happen, but got postponed. That is only the amendment which happened here. Fifth one amendment likho. Fourth wala strike off karo. Not relevant right now because wo event kab ka ho gaya. Fourth one ko strike off karke likho. Fifth three is not required. Fourth one strike off and write like this. Please strike off the fourth one and write like this. I'm writing on the right hand side. Here, write this. Fourth tree mein likhna hai, strike off karke. Services provided by FIFA or to FIFA. I hope you know the full form of FIFA, Federation of International Football Association. Federation for International Football Association. Federation for International Football Association, provided by FIFA or to FIFA, related to FIFA under 17, U17 under 17 Women's World Cup in India, to be held in India. ये फोर्थ ट्री में कॉपी करना है आपको. चलो, सर्विसेज प्रोवाइडेड बाय फीफा और टू फीफा रिलेटेड टू फीफा अंडर 17 इंक्लूडिंग सब्सिडरीज, इंक्लूडिंग सब्सिडरीज रिलेटिंग टू फीफा अंडर 17 वुमेन्स वर्ल्ड कप to be held in India. Those are exempt, sir. Clear? So this completes third type of industry, that is admission services. Number one was transportation of passenger, number two healthcare, number three admission services, number four analysis. This I'll take at the end. Transportation of goods. First one was passenger transportation. This is goods. I'll come to by the end of the video. So we'll come to next page. We'll cover 5. We'll cover 6. Then we'll go to 4. Entertainment sector. Which sector? Entertainment sector. This I will give a note format. If you want to write, please write. But I'll tell you when to write. Before that, you don't write, please. Entertainment sector. Okay. So now, services first category performed by artist. Services performed by artist, either it should be folk performance or classical performance, folk or classical, either in music way, dance, Kathakali and all, or theater. Services performed by an artist, either folk or classical, in the music form, dance form, or theater form. Not as brand ambassador.
not as brand ambassador or as a brand ambassador. Now listen, listen. I know my friend, she is a trained classical dancer. She is a trained classical dancer. Okay, now Pinnacle Academy is having a annual day function where I have called my friend to perform on the stage. She is a trained classical dancer. Now she said, I will come and perform, but I want money. Now I asked, how much money you want? Is it less than 1,50,000 or greater than 1,50,000? I'm telling, asking my friend, you want this amount? She's telling, why are you asking like this? So I'm telling now, if you want less than 1,00,000, I need not pay GST to you. So if you say that I want 1,00,000, I'll pay you 1,00,000 plus zero. But if you say you want 3,00,000, I will pay 3,00,000 plus GST to you. But you are coming not to promote Pinnacle, you are coming to promote the classical dance. That's called not as a brand ambassador. As a brand ambassador, Hema Malini, I don't know how many of you know, Hema Malini, she is a brand ambassador of Kent Purifier. Kent company called her on their annual function day to perform. She is also a trained classical dancer. There she is promoting the product. Which product? Kent. If she is coming as a brand ambassador, it is taxable. There we don't check whether amount is less than 1.5 or more than 1.5. Am I clear? Note number 2, if you are doing a coaching center hai aapka related to dance, you are a choreographer, you have a dance academy, music, you know how to play a piano, you are running piano classes. Sports, you are a cricket coach. These are exempt. Ante, if I am running a coaching academy of dance, I'll collect fees from the students. I'll collect fees plus zero. However, if I am running coaching centers apart from these three, I will collect the coaching fees plus GST. For example, time, a coaching center for MBA, CAT examination preparation, they will collect coaching fees plus GST. Pinnacle Academy will not come here, but it is taxable. It means their services are also taxable under GST, but we will not collect GST from the students because GST will come when you go for registration. Registration will come if the turnover exceeds 10 lakhs, 20 lakhs, 40 lakhs. That all nonsense also you should keep in mind. Now, I perform in TV, I perform in web series, I perform in TV shows, movies. It's not covered in this category. Bole to, if it's not covered in this category, it is not exempt. Bole to, it is taxable. It means they have to pay 100 plus GST. That's called entertainment sector coaching concept. Only the coaching of these three are exempt. If you provide coaching of other than these three, it is taxable. Consideration charged. Ye copy kar lo hona to chalo. She is not coming as a brand ambassador. Per event. This is your category industry number 5, entertainment sector. I told you we'll cover 6 industries.
देन विल गो टू सिक्स देन विल गो टू फोर एंड वाइंड अप द सेशन बिकॉज इफ आई कवर मन विल गो मैड. मैं वापस बोल रहा हूँ, आई एम होल्डिंग माई हैंड्स. द मोमेंट वीडियो इज डन टेक अ ब्रेक. आई नो यू विल टेक अ ब्रेक बट आफ्टर टू थ्री आवर्स प्लीज रिवाइज 1 to 6 इंडस्ट्रीज. वेरी वेरी मच 1 to 6 यू हैव टू रिवाइज प्लीज. चलो स्टार्ट कॉपिंग दिस देन आई टेल यू टू रीड. फर्स्ट कॉपी करो. चलो If you're coming as a brand, it's taxable irrespective of the amount. Remember that also. ठीक है हो गया सर. शैल वी कंटिन्यू चेक. हेलो ओके इफ इट्स डन नाउ रीड दिस. रीड दिस अगेन. आई एम टेलिंग आई एम नॉट कवरिंग व्हाट आर टैक्सेबल. आई एम कवरिंग व्हाट इज एग्जेम्प्ट. सो इन द एग्जाम इफ यू गिव्स एनीथिंग व्हाट एवर आई एम कवरिंग दोस आर टैक्सेबल. लाइक सर्विसेज ऑफ टीवी सीरियल्स इज नॉट कवर्ड बाई इन माई इन दिस इन दिस. Movies, Western dance, because only folk dance and classical is covered. Those are taxable. So please padho acche se chalo. ठीक है. दिस इज विच सेक्टर सर? एंटरटेनमेंट सेक्टर. वी कवर्ड ट्रांसपोर्टेशन ऑफ पैसेंजर, हेल्थ केयर, एडमिशन, एंटरटेनमेंट सेक्टर. नाउ विल गो टू स्पोर्ट्स सेक्टर. विल गो टू स्पोर्ट्स सेक्टर. ओके नाउ लिसन, इसका भी नोट्स बना के दे देता हूँ मैं, सुन लो देन यू कैन रीड. विच सेक्टर? स्पोर्ट्स सेक्टर. फर्स्ट वन, सर्विसेस प्रोवाइडेड. By individual, by to recognized sports body that individual can be a player, can be a coach, can be a referee, can be umpire, can be team manager. Please understand, recognized sports body बोलते BCCI ले लो, best example, are exempt. अब इसका logic समझा तुम सुनो. Player assuming Virat Kohli, I don't know how many of you know he is a captain of Indian cricket team. He will also get around 7 to 8 crores per annum. BCCI will make the payment to him. Who will make? BCCI will make to Virat Kohli for playing matches for India. Okay? They will make the payment. BCCI make Virat Kohli. So, which service provider? Virat Kohli. Service recipient? BCCI. How much BCCI is paying? 7 crores. So, who is providing services to whom? Virat Kohli is providing service to BCCI. As a result, BCCI is paying 7 crores to Virat Kohli. Those services are exempt. Bolto, it will be 7 crores plus 0. But if you are providing as a player, referee, coach, umpire, team manager, referee, coach, you know, coach, Ravi Shastri, umpire, you know, team manager. But if you are providing apart from these 5, it is taxable. I am a commentator. Is it covered here? No, taxable. I am a cheer boy, cheer girl leader. I am a pitch curator. I am a member of selection committee. It's not covered here. Only 5 things are covered here. Player, referee, coach, umpire, team manager. Those are exempt. If you are providing apart from these 5, I am a commentator, I am a curator, I am cheer girl, member of selection committee, then that is not covered here. Those are taxable. सो अपने को ये याद रखना है विच आर एग्जेम्प्ट अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट दैट आर टैक्सेबल. क्लियर? सेकंड वन, सर्विसेस प्रोवाइडेड बाय वन रिकॉग्नाइज्ड बॉडी टू अनदर रिकॉग्नाइज्ड बॉडी दैट इज आल्सो एग्जेम्प्ट. BCCI to Badminton Association, Badminton to Table Tennis Association, all those are exempt. Number 3, services provided by FIFA to anyone or to FIFA, those are also exempt. Now listen, before you note down, we have 4 categories here, 1, 2, 3 and 4. This you write only for knowledge, third one. Exam ke liye nahi puchhenga, don't worry. Third one, you not worry about it. Wo itta bada nahi puchta exam ke liye. Copy this and then read the 6th sector, what we covered. Chalo. First copy this and then read the 6th sector. Chalo, come on guys, chalo, chalo. So if you are providing services to BCI as a commentator, chair girl, pitch curator, selection committee member, it's not covered here. बोल तो these are not exempt. बोल तो these are taxable. ऐसा दिमाग में बैठाना आप लोग. ठीक है, इज इट डन? नाउ प्लीज रीड दिस. वन सेकेंड. चलो रीड दिस प्लीज. आई रिपीट, डोंट रीड द थर्ड वन, दैट्स नॉट रिक्वायर्ड फॉर योर एग्जामिनेशन पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू. यू रीड 1, 2, 4, दैट मोर देन इनफ. ये एग्जेम्प्ट है, ये टैक्सेबल है, ये एग्जेम्प्ट है, ये भी एग्जेम्प्ट है. ठीक है, चलो 6th one इज डन. नाउ द लास्ट वन फॉर द डे. ट्रांसपोर्टेशन ऑफ गुड्स सर्विसेस. बोल तो फर्स्ट वन में यू वर ट्रांसपोर्टिंग द पैसेंजर्स पीपल, नाउ यू ट्रांसपोर्टिंग द गुड्स. नेक्स्ट व्हाट हैपेंस वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड. यू से स्टार्ट, वी स्टार्ट. नाउ लिसन. Now listen, please listen. It's better I'll give the chart for you. बिकॉज दैट इज गिवन करेक्टली ओनली, बट थोड़ा कन्फ्यूजन में है वो, सुन लो. ट्रांसपोर्टेशन ऑफ गुड्स सर्विसेस Although you are transporting goods from one place to another. Now listen. Category 1. You are transporting the goods by railways or ship. Ship is called vessel. You are transporting goods from by railways or ship. Which good? Agricultural produce. I am a farmer. I am sending my food grains from Hyderabad to Goa by train. By train. Should I pay freight charges to railways? Yes. Now the question is, should I pay GST also on that? Government clarified. Now what? Those are exempt services. Bolto, I will only pay the freight charges, I will not pay the GST. What are they transporting? Agricultural produce, defense material. Bolto, they are transporting guns for the defense, they are transporting milk, they are transporting salt, they are transporting magazines. They are transporting organic manure. They are transporting railway equipments. Relief material. Relief also some nonsense happening in some area and we are providing food there. चलो वंस अगेन दिस इज ए दिस इज बी सुनते जाओ वापिस लेट अस रीड यू आर ट्रांसपोर्टिंग गुड्स बाय वे ऑफ रेलवेज और शिप एंड यू आर ट्रांसपोर्टिंग दीज गुड्स सो दैट रेलवे फेलो विल ओनली चार्ज फ्राइट चार्जेस एंड नो जीएसटी एंड इफ यू ट्रांसपोर्ट एनी अदर गुड विच इज नॉट कवर्ड अबव नॉट कवर्ड above, then those are taxable. Bolto, on that he will charge freight charges also, on that he will ask you to pay tax GST also. This is by railways or ship. Second one will cover transport of goods by roadways. By roadways, ठीक है उसमें क्या करना आप you have to copy this list as it is but do not copy railway equipment point here shall copy 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. You have 8 items, you will copy only 7 items. Apart from railway equipment, and again you will write here exempt services. That is A. B may you will write same. Any other good apart from those, again you will write taxable. Chalo, yahan tak likho pehle. Start writing because notes also given clearly but this I'm giving more clarity chal this is your fourth industry I guess first one was transportation of passengers second one healthcare third one admission fourth one goods and transportation of goods फिफ्थ वन एंटरटेनमेंट एंड सिक्स वन स्पोर्ट्स सेक्टर.
चलो स्टार्ट. जल्दी लिखो सर प्लीज क्विक.
सर इवन दो यू हैव द नोट्स इन द नोटबुक अगेन आई एम राइटिंग इन अदर लैंग्वेज अदर फॉर्मैट यू विच एवर यू फील कंफर्टेबल यू फॉलो दैट आई हैव नो इश्यूज विद दैट. More 1 minute I'm giving you to copy, please copy. ठीक है डन. चलो बिलो दैट स्टार्ट राइटिंग नाउ. सर्विस लिसन नाउ फर्स्ट. सर्विसेज प्रोवाइड बाय जीटीए जीटीए ऑफ द गुड्स ट्रांसपोर्ट एजेंसी बाय रोड टू गारमेंट कंपनी. आई एम अ ट्रांसपोर्ट कंपनी. आई एम ट्रांसपोर्टिंग गुड्स विच बिलोंग्स टू अ गारमेंट कंपनी एग्जेम्प्ट. बोलता आई विल ओनली चार्ज द प्राइसेस. आई कैन नॉट चार्ज जीएसटी बिकॉज द अमाउंट इज पेड बाय गारमेंट local authority GHMC government agency. So if I am a transport company, I am giving services to these people, exempt. And in case services provided by GTA via road where the bill amount is less than 750 per consignment or 1500 for total consignments, if the small area means the truck is going within 3 kilometers, 5 kilometers, 10 kilometers, where you're charging less than 750, small amount, exempt from GST. Note number 2, don't write now, listen. Now, railways is done, waterways here, railways is done, roadways is done, we'll go to waterways. Transport of goods from inland waterways, whether through ship, that is also exempt. And note 3, only airways is pending now. Transport of goods by airways. Well, I want to send certain immediate parcel from Hyderabad to Goa via flight. Through SpiceJet. SpiceJet will say you have to pay charges, freight charges. Now the question is, should I pay GST on freight charges? Yes or no? That's what we are learning. Transportation of goods by airways from, if the flight is coming from outside India to India. For example, my friend, a flight is coming from USA to India, Hyderabad, through SpiceJet. My friend has sent a parcel through the flight which is coming from USA outside India to India. These are exempt. Bolto, my friend will pay only the freight charges to the company. He will not pay GST. Second one. From India to India. Boleto. Flight is going from Hyderabad to Goa, that is from India to India, that is also exempt. And this is USA to India. If you observe carefully, one scenario is not covered. If the flight is going from India to USA, it's not covered in the list. Boleto, it is not exempt. Boleto, it is taxable. If I want to send a parcel from India to USA via SpiceJet, I have to pay charges to SpiceJet plus GST. If flight is coming from USA to India, no GST. Flight is going anywhere in India, no GST. But GST will come when the flight is going from India to outside India. Outside India to India, exempt. India to India, exempt. It means India to outside India will be taxable. Clear? Copy this. And we'll see in the next video. Have a nice day. Thank you so much. And then do this also, please. 2 minutes I'm giving you to copy this. Please start copying. Have a nice day. Thank you. Have a nice day, sir. Thank you so much. Please pause the video. Thank you.